I just think it's such a thrill to be nominated and for all of us to be here and have sort of just to give ourselves a night out from working in Halifax on the cobbled streets is a great thing. But we're also really missing the cast who aren't with us tonight, who are all valiantly working away and doing the real stuff. We're out having a glamorous night out. But we're so thrilled to be nominated against the Crown and the End of the F***ing World. So that's a great thing. And we would never have expected to be here. So thanks for having us.
There's nothing like it on TV right now, and there hasn't been for a long time. So, I mean, not to blow our own trumpet, but it's pretty groundbreaking. So I think, and that's why we're up against shows like The Crown and The End of the F***ing World.
It's a fun.
Make sure that I get that word perfect. And I feel really bad saying the word f***ing as well.
No, we know that there's a complete lack of diversity in many aspects of television. I think Ackley Bridge has really embraced that, where diversity is really important to it, but it's not the overpowering thing either. Some great stories. The writers have worked really hard on this, and I think it's a really important show, and bringing a young audience to Channel 4, you know, and television, you know, terrestrial television desperately needs young people watching again, and I think this show is trying to do that, and it's doing it really well.
I think the word diversity is one that we continue to debate. Do you feel that that is a word that we are embracing more? Is our screen more diverse than it was 10 years ago, 20 years ago?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's becoming, you know, something that's not just a policy, but something that's really important and vital for the future of television and film everywhere, really. And I'm glad that Ackley Bridge is sort of leading the way of that on terrestrial TV.